Consider the next type of curve, polar curves. In polar system, there is one fixed point O called as pole, and if you draw a straight line passing through O, say OX, then that is called as the initial line. Let P be any point, then vector OP bar is called as a radius vector, and it is generally denoted by R bar, and length of that vector is R. Angle made by vector OP bar with x axis, that we call as a vectorial angle, and it is generally denoted by theta, and it is measured in anti-clockwise direction. Look at this figure. P is any point, then vector joining origin to P is OP bar, and length of this vector, distance of P from origin, is R, and angle made by OP with positive x axis is theta, and it is measured in anti-clockwise direction. Now we'll see what are the points by making use of which we can trace polar curve. The first point is symmetry. By replacing theta by minus theta, if the equation of curve remains unchanged, then the curve is symmetric about x-axis, or it is also called as the initial line. By replacing theta by minus theta and r by minus r, if the equation of curve remains unchanged, then the curve is symmetric about the line perpendicular to initial line passing through pole, that is nothing but y-axis. Next is pole, where to find the values of theta for which r become 0, then the curve passes through pole. And if it passes through pole, then there is a tangent at pole. To get that equation of tangent, just put the value of r equal to 0 and find the values of theta. There is one more way to find a tangent, which is making angle phi with x-axis. For that, we have to consider the equation tan phi is equal to r into d theta by dr, and put theta equal to 0 in that equation. That gives us phi, and that is the tangent making angle with positive x-axis at theta equal to 0. Next is limitations of the curve. We have to find the extreme values of r for proper values of theta. Then we have to make one table which contains the values of theta and r. Generally we take the values of theta from 0 to 2 pi. Okay. And depending on the symmetry, we can take the corresponding values of theta. Now we'll take some problems on polar curve. Trace the curve r square equal to a square into cos 2 theta. First, draw the coordinate axis. Then replace theta by minus theta. Check whether it gives us the same equation again. Then we can say that the curve is symmetric about x-axis or not. Replace theta by minus theta and r by minus r. If you again get the same equation, then the curve is symmetric about y-axis. So replace the corresponding term and check the symmetry. In this equation, if we replace theta by minus theta, we get a square into cos of 2 into minus theta, and cos of minus theta is same as cos theta, so we get again the same equation. And if we replace r by minus r and theta by minus theta, okay, then also we get the same equation. Minus of r square is same as r square, and cos of minus theta is cos theta. So it is symmetric about x-axis as well as y-axis. It is symmetric about both axes. So whatever curve in the upper half get reflected in lower half, and whatever curve in right half get reflected in left half. So it is enough to draw the curve in first quadrant. By symmetry, we get it in other three quadrant. Now next point is pole. We have to find the value of theta for which r becomes 0, and for theta equal to pi by 4, we get cos pi by 2, and cos pi by 2 is 0, so r becomes 0. So the curve passes through pole. And then next point is tangent at pole. Just put r equal to 0, find a value of theta. When r is equal to 0, cos 2 theta becomes 0, that is 2 theta is nothing but pi by 2, so theta will be pi by 4. So there is a tangent at pole, that is nothing but theta is equal to pi by 4. and theta equal to pi by 4, it is a line making angle pi by 4 with x axis, passing through pole and making angle pi by 4 with x axis. So that line is like this. This green line is a tangent at pole, that is origin. Now we have to find a tangent making angle pi with x axis. So for that we have to consider the equation tan phi is equal to r into d theta by dr and then simplify it. So consider the equation tan phi is equal to r into d theta by dt, d theta by dr. Take the derivative of given equation on both sides. So it will be 2r into a square into derivative of cos 2 theta is minus 2 sin 2 theta into derivative of theta, that is d theta by dr. Take all the terms on one side. So d theta by dr is minus r upon a square into sin 2 theta. Put these values back to this equation. So tan phi is minus r square upon a square into sin 2 theta. And r square is nothing but a square into cos 2 theta. So putting that value, a square get cancelled. Cos by sin is cot. So tan phi is minus cot 2 theta. And cot of minus cot 2 theta is nothing but tan of 2 theta plus pi by 2. Okay, so we get this equation. Tan phi is equal to tan of pi by 2 plus 2 theta. So phi will be pi by 2 plus 2 theta. And now put theta equal to 0 into it. So we get a tangent making angle pi by 2 with x axis at a distance r equal to plus or minus a. Okay, we are putting theta equal to 0 into this equation. So r square become a square, that is r equal to plus or minus a. Okay, so theta equal to 0 is nothing but x axis, r equal to plus a, take a point at a distance a from origin and now draw a tangent passing through this point making angle pi by 2 with x axis. So that line will be like this. So this is a tangent at r equal to a. The next point is limitations. There are limitations for cos. Cos value always lies between plus 1 and minus 1. So when cos take plus 1 value, r square will be a square. So r is less equal a. Okay, so r equal to less equal a is nothing but a limitation. So it is all the set of points which are at a distance less than or equal to a. And r equal to a, that is nothing but a circle of radius a. So all the points inside that circle is a limitation. We'll have the curve within this circle of radius a. Now we have to plot the points. We have to make one table which contains the values of r and theta. As it is symmetric about both axes, so take the values of theta from 0 to pi by 2. So make one table which contains these values. When theta is 0, r square is equal to a square, so r will be a. When theta is equal to pi by 2, pi by 4, this become cos of pi by 2, cos pi by 2 is 0, so r become 0. When theta is equal to pi by 2, this become cos pi and cos pi is minus 1, so r square become minus a square. So it become imaginary. So there is no point on y axis. Okay, at theta equal to pi by 2, r become imaginary, so there is no point at theta equal to pi by 2. So we'll just take these two points. So we are having these two points. This green line is a tangent at this point. This green line is a tangent at this point. So draw the curve for which this line become tangent and this line become tangent at this point. Okay, so curve will be like this. Okay, we cannot have the curve on other side because we are having a curve within the circle only. So there is no curve on this side. There is no curve on this side because if you draw the curve, then somewhere it will intersect y-axis. But as we saw, for theta equal to pi by 2, r is imaginary. So there is no curve on this side. There is no y-intercept. Okay, so no curve on this side. So we'll have curve only on this side. So that this green line is a tangent at this point and we have a curve like this for which this green line is a tangent at this point. And now draw the curve which join these two parts and now by symmetry draw it in the other quadrant. So this is how that cup look like. There is one special name for this cup. This is also called as a laminiscate. Now consider the next cup. R is equal to A into 1 plus cos theta. First draw the coordinate axis. Now replace theta by minus theta. Check whether we get the same equation again. If it is same equation again, then it is symmetric about x axis. Replace theta by minus theta, R by minus R. If you get same equation, then it is symmetric about y-axis. So firstly, we'll check the symmetry. If we replace theta by minus theta, then we get A into 1 plus cos of minus theta. Cos of minus theta is same as cos theta. So again, we get the same equation. A into 1 plus cos theta equal to R. So it is symmetric about x-axis. But if we replace theta by minus theta and R by minus R, okay, then we will not get the same equation. This side will remain same, but here we get minus R, that is not same as the original equation. So curve is not symmetric about y-axis. It is symmetric only about x-axis. So curve is symmetric about x-axis. So whatever curve in the upper half, it get reflected in lower half. Now next point is pole. We have to get the value of theta for which R become 0. And you can see that for theta equal to pi, cos pi is minus 1, minus 1 plus 1 becomes 0, so R becomes 0. So the curve passes through pole. If it passes through pole, there is a tangent at pole. Just put R equal to 0 and find the value of theta. When R equal to 0, A into 1 plus cos theta becomes 0. So taking all the terms on one side, cos theta will be minus 1. And cos theta is minus 1 when theta is equal to pi. So theta equal to pi is nothing but tangent at pole. So theta equal to pi is nothing but the angle made with the positive x-axis, so it will be negative x-axis. So that is theta equal to pi. So this negative x-axis is a tangent at pole. Now we have to find a tangent making angle phi. So we have to consider the equation tan phi is equal to R into d theta by dr. So take the equation tan phi is equal to R into d theta by dr. Take a derivative of given equation. Derivative of R is 1. A into derivative of cos theta is minus sin theta d theta by dr. Take all the terms on one side. So d theta by dr is minus 1 upon A into sin theta. Put this value back to this equation. So tan phi is equal to R into all this term. Minus 1 upon A sin theta. But R is A into 1 plus cos theta. So putting that value, we get this. Now we'll further simplify this. Use half angle formulas. 1 plus cos theta is 2 cos square theta by 2. Sin theta is 2 sin theta by 2 cos theta by 2. A get cancelled. So it becomes minus cot theta by 2. Okay, 1 cos get cancelled. Cos by sin is cot. And minus cot is nothing but tan of theta by 2 plus pi by 2. So we get tan phi is equal to tan of theta by 2 plus pi by 2. So phi is equal to theta by 2 plus pi by 2, and then put theta equal to 0 into that, we get phi is equal to pi by 2. And if we put theta equal to 0 into the given equation, cos theta is cos 0 is 1, 1 plus 1 2 into a, so R will be 2a. So there is a tangent at angle theta equal to 0 at a distance R equal to 2a from origin, making angle pi by 2 with x-axis. So theta equal to 0 is nothing but x-axis, R equal to 2a. It is a point at a distance 2a from origin, and at this point draw a line which makes angle pi by 2 with x-axis, and that is nothing but perpendicular to x-axis. So this line is tangent at this point. Now next point is limitation. Now we have to find the extreme values of R. We know the extreme values of cos theta, it is plus 1 and minus 1. So when it is plus 1, 1 plus 1, 2 into a. So maximum value of R is 2a. So all the points lies within a circle of radius 2a. Okay, so draw a circle of radius 2a. We'll have a curve within this circle because R equal to 2a. Is the point at a distance 2a from origin, that is nothing but a circle, and less equal means all the points inside it. So curve lies within this circle. Now we have to make a table which contains different values of theta and corresponding values of r. As it is symmetric only about x-axis, so take the values of theta between 0 to pi. Okay, you can take different values. So we take the values of theta as 0. For theta equal to 0, cos 0 is 1. 1 plus 1 into a, that is 2a. So r will be 2a. So this is theta equal to 0, r equal to 8, passes to this point. Next is theta equal to pi by 4. So when theta is equal to pi by 4, cos pi by 4 is 1 by root 2. So multiply a inside, we get a plus a by root 2. And a plus a by root 2 is little smaller than 2a. So take a line which makes angle pi by 4 with the x-axis. This is theta equal to pi by 4. Take a point which is at a distance a plus a by root 2. So take a point which is having a distance smaller than this 2a. So somewhere here you take that point and that is a plus a by root 2. Then put theta is equal to pi by 2. When theta is pi by 2, okay, cos pi by 2 is 0, so r become a. So we are having a point at theta equal to pi by 2 at a distance a. Now a is smaller than a plus a by root 2. So take a point which is at a smaller distance than this. So take a point on this theta equal to pi by 2. So this is r equal to a. And take next point 3 pi by 4. At theta equal to 3 pi by 4, cos 3 pi by 4 is minus 1 by root 2. So we get r equal to a minus a by root 2. This is again smaller than a. So first draw a line which is at angle 3 pi by 4 with x axis, and this distance is smaller than a. So we are having a point which is at a distance smaller than this distance. So somewhere here you take that point a minus a by root 2. Then last point theta equal to pi, r will be 0. So when theta is pi, cos pi is minus 1, r becomes 0. So it passes to this point. So we are having a curve passing through these points, and these green lines are tangent and it is within this circle. Okay, now we know that how the curve is at a tangent. We'll have a curve like this, then it pass through these points and then pass through origin, so that it will this green line become tangent. So curve will be like this. Okay, these green lines are tangent and passing through these points, and by symmetry draw it in the lower half. So this is how that curve look like. This curve also has one special name. This curve is also called as a cardioid.